this address, baby. You are watching Fountain TV. And welcome to another episode of ENT 321, Accounting for Business Manager. ENT 321, this is the episode 2 of ENT 321. The episode 1, we talk about what an accounting means, and bookkeeping, and some use of accounting information. So in this episode, we are going to look at some outline. So first, we are going to look at characteristic of a useful information. Characteristic of a useful information. The information provided by the accountant. The features that the information are. The second one, we are going to look at the double entry principle. The double entry principle. Double entry principle. And last one, I'm going to look at the accounting equation. The accounting equation. Accounting equation. So let's start from the first outline, which is characteristic of a useful information. Characteristic. So we are talking about characteristics of a, you know, in the first episode, we talk about some information that the feature of an accountant, that an accountant is the one that provides information to the useful all people who the information is being used to. So the information provided by the an accountant must have some feature, must have some characteristics. So we are going to look at this characteristic of that information. So the first one, the information must be reliable. Second one is objectivity. Third one is flexibility. And the last one, understandability. So there are still so many characteristics that the information. We are just going to look at this four because of our time. So we are talking about reliability. The information that must be provided by the accountant must be accurate and must be complete. The information provided by the accountant must be accurate and to be complete. It must be able to be verified by an investor. So all the information that the accountant will provide must be accurate and complete. So that the information must be reliable. So the second one is objectivity. We are talking about objectivity. The information provided by the accountant must not based on any mutual consent. The information must not support any party. Must not be in support of any party. It must be in neutral. So because and I cannot may think that I want to provide this information in order to be in support of the company, but the information must not be in support of any party. The information provided by the accountant must be neutral for every party that information will go to. So the next one is flexibility. We are talking about flexibility. Well, the information provided by the accountant must be. When the information is to be carried out, it must not involve any cost. The cost must not be too much or must not be high. What we are trying to say is that if the information is to be implemented, so there must not be any cost on the information that is being provided by the accountant. So the last one is understandability. We're talking about understandable. The information provided by the accountant must be very simple and easy to understand by any person that the information is going to. So it must have some business data that must be understood by everyone. So it must not be hard at all. So these are some of the characteristics of the useful information that must be provided, that is being presented by an accountant. So let's go to the second outline because of our time. So let's go to the third double entry principle. So when you're talking about the double entry principle, in every business transaction, there are usually twofold. The double entry principle. There in every present transaction, there are usually two folds that occur. One is for the person giving out the goods. And the other one is for the person receiving the goods. So the person giving out the goods, that the person giving out the goods, the good is going to be credited, while the person receiving the good is going to be debited. So the double entry principle. So let's go to what the double entry principle states. The double entry principle states that for every double entry principle. It states that for every for every credit entry, there must be a corresponding debit entry and vice versa. In other words, we can say for every, the double entry principle states that for every credit entry, there must be a corresponding debit entry. And vice versa. What I mean by vice versa is for every credit entry, there must be a corresponding debit entry, and for every debit entry, there must be a corresponding credit entry. So that is what the double entry principle is. You know, when I'm talking about delivery of goods, some people will be receiving the goods and some people will be giving out the goods. So when I'm talking about the double entry principle, so the debit, let's talk about the credit is the giver. Is the person giving out the goods. While debit is the receiver. The person receiving the goods is going to be debited, while the person giving out the goods is going to be credited. So the double entry principle is being shown like this. On the table. It has one table like this. This, the debit is always at the right, at the left hand side. Why credit is always at the right hand side. So that is double entry principle. So let's just know that the double entry principle states that for every credit entry, there must be a corresponding debit entry, and for every debit entry, there must be a corresponding credit entry. Why? Debit is the receiver and credit is the giver. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So let's just note all this. Point. So that is what the double entry principle. So let's go to the last part now of today's episode, which is accounting equation. So when I'm talking about accounting equation, in every business organization, when I'm talking about accounting equation, in every business organization, there are some goods, there are some items that is being owned by the company, that by the business, which is being called assets, and there are some goods that the company is being owned, that the company did not have full claims over it, which this serves as a liability to the company. So this big about accounting equation in accounting. So the accounting equation serves as a statement of equality in every business organization. So when talking about accounting equation. It serves as a statement of equality where the resources is equal to the sources. The resources that are being used to produce the business in an organization is equal to where the money is being got from. So let's take a look at the accounting equation. The accounting equation is assets equal to capital plus liability. This accounting equation. Asset equal to capital plus liability. We are talking about assets. Asset is what is being owned by a company, that the company has full claim over it. We are talking about our machineries, our buildings, our furnitures, the goods, the cash in hand. That is an example of assets. Our machinery, the furniture, then the machinery, the building is an example of asset. So we're talking about capital. Capital is what is being used to start up a business, to invest in a business, either liquid or cash. So a liability, we're talking about liability. Liability is what is being owned by the company to outsiders. So that is liability. We're talking about liability. We're talking about loan. Back overdraft is an example of liability. Being payable is also an example of liability. It's what is being owned by the company to outsiders. So we can also say that this asset equal to capital plus liability. We can also say that capital equal to asset minus liability. And liability equal to assets minus capital. It's just a change of formula for the calculation. Just a change of formula for it. So let's just take a look at maybe three examples because of our time. Three examples of accounting equation. Just simple three examples. So well, the first example is assets. They give our assets as 10,000 naira. The amount of our assets is 10,000 naira. Our capital is 2,000 naira. Where our liability, we are told to find our liability. So I know the formula is assets equal to capital minus liability. So the formula for liability is, let's not forget, liability. So we are going to use the formula for liability equal to assets minus capital. So liability, L we stand for our liability, and our assets, how much is our asset? Is 10,000 naira. 10,000 naira. How much is our capital? 2,000 naira. So our liability will be 10,000 minus 2,000 naira, that is 8,000 naira. 8,000 naira. So this is our first example. So let's look at the second example. Our capital is, they give our, the second example is capital as 3,000 naira. Liability as 2,000 naira. And our assets, we are told to find our assets. So and we know the formula for finding assets. So assets, let's represent our asset as A equal to capital as C plus liability. So assets equal to 3,000 naira plus 2,000 naira. So our assets equal to 5,000 naira. So that is second. So let's take the last example because of our time. So we are giving our building. The last example, building as 5,000 naira. Loan as 2,000 naira. And you are told to find our capital. So don't let this one convince you, because I've defined what an asset means and what a liability means. We are talking about an asset. An asset is what is being owned by a company. So a building is an example of an asset, and a loan is an example of liability. Liability is being owned by, is what is being owned by a company to outsider. So this building also represent our asset, while our loan also represent our liability. So you can come across this questions. So
let's we are talking to find our capital. So the formula for capital is capital represented as C. Assets, which is our building minus minus liability. Let's represent it as L, which is our loan. So capital equal to assets, which is our building 5,000 naira minus liability, which is our loan 2,000 naira. So capital equal to 3,000 naira. So these are the example of accounting equation. So we have talked in this episode, we have talked about the characteristic of useful information. We talk about the reliability, objectivity, stability, and we also talk about the double entry principle, the debit the giver, debit the receiver, credit the giver. And the double entry principle states that for every debit entry, there must be a corresponding credit entry, and vice versa. And we also talk about the accounting equation. The accounting equation, which we talk about our assets, the liability, and the capital. So this will be the end of our today episode. So you can drop your questions or suggestions in the comment box, and also join us next time.